Honey, don't buy me that. We ain't married yet. Don't get me that. We ain't married yet. Don't go to Victoria's Secret. I ain't ready to tell you my secrets just yet. You got honey. If you like it, then you better put a ring on it. The people that sow into your life, stop taking handouts from everybody. Stop being so quick to receive everything somebody gonna give you. Can I say this, sisters? Sometime you got to learn how to reject some gifts. Oh, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Sometimes you got to say, I know that you want to take me out, but the price I'm going to really have to pay for this meal I'm getting ready to eat really ain't worth it. Sometimes you got to learn that I'm not going to take everything. Somebody, y'all ain't going, y'all messing up. Honey, don't buy me that. We ain't married yet. Don't get me that. We ain't married yet. Don't go to Victoria's Secret. I ain't ready to tell you my secrets just yet. You got honey, if you like it, then you better put a ring on it. Yeah, because I'm confident.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to put Beyonce in my message this morning. So. My confidence is a God thing. Now watch this. Acts 5:5-39 says this. According to the NIV version, it says this. But if it is from God, you will not be able to stop these men. Now, you are these men. Greater Emmanuel Temple are these men. The mothers that showed up for Mother's Day are these men. And the Bible says, no matter what is up against you, according to the text this morning, if it is from God, Joshua 1:9 says, have not I commanded? But then Acts 5:39 says, if it be of God. So for everybody that is in this room, if God has commanded you, then the latter part of Acts 5:39 is for you. You will not be able to stop these men. So let me say this to everybody in this room. First of all, let me just take a poll for a moment. How many of you know you got a promise over your life? How many of you know the reason why you haven't died under the pressure that you're under now is because there's a promise over your life? How many of you know the reason why you survived to the season that you're in right now is because there's a promise over your life? How many of you know the reason why you're getting ready to put your foot on the devil's neck and literally suffocate him is because there's a promise over your life? Well, if there's a promise over your life, the women ought to be getting this. If there's a promise over your life, then Acts 5:39 says you need to dry your eyes and stop running around the church like you're getting ready to lose. Because the text says you will not be able to stop you. You will not be able to stop these men. Now, there's about 200 of these men. And I'm going to tell you that just because it says men in the text doesn't mean it's not talking about women. There's some women that are in this house. But God said in this season, because I commanded you, I anointed you to be unstoppable. So here it is. No matter what you're facing on Mother's Day, I'm going to tell you to praise your way through, because whatever is in front of you is not bigger than what's behind you. There is an anointing that's got your back. There is a power that's got your back. There is a glory that's got your back. There is an authority that's got your back. That if you would start complaining and start speaking in the name of Jesus, David said, I don't come to you like everybody else does, but I come to you in the name of the Lord. When is the last time you used the name of Jesus on your finance? When is the last time you used the name of Jesus on your health? Sometimes you got to learn, mothers, how to take your hand and lay it on yourself and say through God's word, I am unstoppable. I am unmovable. I cannot be hindered. I cannot be obstructed.
anointed. I am the righteousness of God. I am the grace of God. And in due season, I'm going to reap. Matter of fact, would you just look over at your neighbor on the left and on the right and tell him, neighbor, the reason you survived the worst of times is because due season is next.